Greetings, greetings, greetings. This is Prophet West coming to you today again. And I just want to give you a word of encouragement today. And today I have a command. God is releasing and God is sending out a command toward and to God's people. And the Bible says that my sheep know my voice, and a stranger they will not follow, which means is that if you have the DNA of God and you belong to him, when he call your name, when he call you, something in you is going to respond, which means is that if it's something in you doesn't respond, then you're not of his. And for those of you that you feel a pulling in your spirit, you feel a pulling, you feel you feel God pulling you, you feel God drawing you near. The reason why he's drawing you near is because he wants to talk to you. He wants to talk to you. He wants to become even more intimate with you. He wants to reveal to you his mind, his plan, his revelation knowledge. He will reveal to you his power, his glory, let you know who you are, and let you know the authority that you walk in. Today, I want to talk about, and the command is, come out of your comfort zone. God is calling you out of your comfort zone. He is. And what are comfort zones? Comfort zones are those things and those places that you're comfortable in. Those places, those habits, even your past relationships, past thoughts, past ways, the people that you hung around, the things that you once did. God wants to call you out of that. He wants to call you out of that. Listen to this in the story. In the Bible, the children of Israel, they were in bondage for 400 years. God raised up a man, Moses, and brought them out of Egypt. And now they went from a place where they were in bondage, but they had everything done regularly all the time, you know, where they worked, they ate, they slept, they worked, they ate, they slept. And so now they're in the wilderness. They're in the wilderness, and God then brought them out. And now they become angry. Now they become angry. Now they become hungry and thirsty. And then they begin to complain. And see, the thing about it, when God brought the children of Israel out of Egypt, and their body was out, but their mind was still in bondage. This is some of you. Your mind is still in the past. Your mind is still in yesterday. See, but today, every day you wake up is a new day. And the Bible lets us know even about the past. See, the past is considered and connected with the dead. And Jesus even told the disciples to let the dead bury the dead. Which means that if you are the light, you hang around and you gravitate to the things that are of the light. And that's where God is calling you out. God is calling you out of your comfort zone. And see, some of you, you've been a silent person. You've taken and you've kept everything to yourself. You hadn't spoken and you hadn't spoke much. See, but now God is calling you to come out. Come out, it's time to speak. And see, because see, sometimes even in relationship, when you're silent, and see, some of you think that being silent is a form of love. It's a form of being patient. It's a form of forbearing. It's a form of just long suffering. No. You're suffering in silence. What's going to happen? The longer you hold your mouth and become quiet, what you're doing, actually, if I can be honest, you are deceiving the person, because you have to let that person know how you feel. You're deceiving that person, and you reap what you sow. So if things are not changing and you're quiet, that's your fault. God wants you to open up your mouth. He wants you to open up your mouth and come out of your comfort zone. Because there's a change that God wants to take place in your life. There is a change. And see, the thing about with those children of Israel that complain in the wilderness, they complain about everything, and they even wish to go back there where they can be comfortable in their comfort zone. And God had called them out and taken them to their place of their promise. Everyone under them that complained, God killed them. Killed them all. The only one that made the cross was Joshua and Caleb. And all those offspring, the kids that were born in the wilderness. The only ones, 21 and down. Kill everybody else because they complain. So at the place where you are right now, and see, a comfort zone is when things are comfortable. But where God is bringing you, and the place that God has brought you to and calling you out of, you're uncomfortable. You're uncomfortable. Because you like control. You like things a certain way where you can fix and you can see certain things before they happen. And so now you can't telegraph certain things, so now you're uncomfortable. And so you think that you're being afflicted. You think it's the adversary. No, it's God. God is making you uncomfortable. That's how you change. That's how you change, and that's how our breaking, that's how deliverance comes, when you're uncomfortable. So it's not the devil. God said this because he's calling you out of your comfort zone. Just like with Elijah. After God had used Elijah to kill all the prophets of Baal, then the man of God, then the king sent, told Jezebel, all that Elijah had done. And Jezebel sent a messenger to Elijah and told him that by tomorrow, the same thing that you did to them is going to happen to you. And so Elijah ran. He ran and then left his servant in one place, then ran again and hid and asked to die. But then the angel strengthened him and gave him food and sent him on his way. So he was on his way. He was on a journey, a day's journey for 40 days and 40 nights. Then he was at this cave. And at this cave, see, a thing about a cave is a place where you're still. Nobody's there but you. Nobody's there but you. Cave, that's where he was at. And at that cave, then he met God, and God began to talk to him. And see, that's where you are right now. You at that cave, and God is calling you at that cave. God want to talk to you. And God want to give you instructions. The same thing in what he gave with Elijah. Because after God talked to him, God gave him some instruction. One thing he told him to go down to the Zarephath and go anoint this one man named Elijah. He's going to be the prophet in the room. Go down there. Go down to this one place in his arm and anoint this one soldier to become king. Captain will become king. And so at the place where you are right now, you're in a pivotal place. But at the place where you are, God is wanting to speak to you. That's why you're uncomfortable. God wants to speak to you. And what in this place of being uncomfortable, what's happening, God is killing your flesh. Your flesh is dying. Your fleshly appetites are dying to this world, this world system. See, because God is trying to give you his appetite. That's why the Bible tells us to love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. Because if any man love the world, the love of the Father is not in him. Because what's in the world is the lust of the flesh, lust of the eye, and the pride of life. It's an appetite. It's a fleshly appetite. Appetite in the eyes. Appetite in the body. Appetite. A craving, then the pride of life. And the pride of life becoming puffed up to a place wherein you don't listen to nobody. Wherein you want what you want. You take what you take. See, God wants to break that. God is bringing you out. That's why you're uncomfortable. That's why you're going through what you're going through. That's why things have become disrupted in your life. See, God said, I didn't come to bring peace. I come to bring a sword. Mother against father and all that in the family. That's divided. Because what God is doing, God is shaking things up that you might come to a place that you come to your senses and come to him. Come to your senses and listen to him. That's why he said in his word, the day that you hear my voice, don't harden your heart. Keep it open that you might be blessed. Come out of that comfort zone. That's why you're discomfort. That's why you're going through what you're going through. Because God wants to speak to you. God wants to heal you. God wants to give you some. God wants to explode in you with wisdom. God wants to explode in you with understanding. Hope this makes sense. God bless you. Bye-bye.